Hello students, I hope you all are safe and healthy. I would expect that you all are doing very nice study. Keep it up. Today we will discuss question answers from the Law Spring lesson. First we will discuss questions of think as you read questions. In that page number 16, you can open page number 16, question number first. What is Sahib looking for in the garbage dumps? Where is he or where has he come from? So here we can think about what was he was searching. We are searching for the gold. Actually that was not the gold, but they would search that something he would get in that garbage dumps. And that will be the means of survival. Then where is he and where has he come from? So here it is clearly mentioned that Simapuri, the place, and that place it is near the periphery of Delhi. And one more thing here it is mentioned, that is where has he come from. And where has he come from? That answer it is given in the beginning itself, and that is page number 11, beginning first passage. So here, Seth Amis, Greenfield of Dhaka, his home is not even distant memory. So here they are the migrants. So here it is clearly mentioned about their earlier places, and that is Dhaka. So it is a simple question. Then what explanations does the author offer for the children not wearing footwears? So here explanations, in that 2-3 explanations here it is given, at least two explanations you can mention. Page number 14, second last passage, there that explanations are given. One here we can observe that question it is asked, why aren't you wearing chappals? So answer is, my mother didn't bring them down from the shelf. That is one explanation given. Then even if CD, he will throw them off, another is adding. Means there, they used to come out and they used to walk as like a barefoot army. So here some explanations are given. But here we can think about them that they don't understand that. I wonder if this is only an excuse to explain a perpetual state of poverty, and in reality they were in the poverty. So we can observe that two things are there. One is the tradition also, being a barefoot, and the second thing is they are in the perpetual never ending poverty. That also you can focus. Is Sahib happy working at tea stall? Explain. So here two views are there. One view here we can think that he was not at all happy because he was not his own master. So ending is, Sahib is no longer his own master. Again one more here it is, line it is, the steel canister seems heavier than the plastic bag he would carry. So here this also it is the negative thing mentioned by the author. So that is also we can observe. And one more thing here again it is reflected, concerned with the thing here. I know, work in the tea stall down the road, he says, pointing in distance. I am paid 800 rupees and all my means. So here one positive thing we can observe, that he is getting the food but he is not free. And due to this, we are observing, finally we can say, it is a personal response question. right? He was not at all happy. As being a child labor, how someone would be happy? Then page number 19, think as you read, what makes the city of Firozabad famous? So here, city of Firozabad was famous for the bangle making, and so many here examples are given about that, and how is that bangle makers families, everything here it is mentioned that every other family of Firozabad is engaged in bangle making. It is the center of India's glass blowing industry, where families have spent generation working around the furnaces, everything. So here, famous for the bangle making, we can state. Then next question, mention the hazards of working in the glass bangle industries. So here you can state especially about the, they were in the poverty generation by generation, due to in that such type of thing. Here some hazards they have mentioned in that. Children liking to work in glass furnaces in high temperature was high, then dingy cells, without air and light, suppose suffocation, such type of. Again, one more thing it is here mentioned about the stinking lanes. Then here some again more examples concerned with that, about the, especially about the Bahu, the word is mentioned, and her condition is also mentioned. Then we can observe the grandmother's also expression. Through that also we can understand, especially their eyes problem. And one more here, page number 18 also, they have mentioned about the problems of the, means even though the sunny gold, paddy green, everything it is mentioned here, their eyes are more adjusted to that dark. Means here it is clearly mentioned that due to such type of problems, they are not at all happy. Their eyesight most of the time become weak. They would become blind and they may not enjoy their life. So here all the things we can observe. Then how is Mukesh's attitude to his situation different from that of his family? So this is important question. Family members, they were more involved in what? The family members, they were more involved in the bangle making business, and generation by generation they were working in the same. But here some expression we can observe, and that expressions are here, ek waqt sher bhar khana bhi nahi khaya. So if we will refer this, we can understand that how is the condition of them. Means here negative things we can observe. Then a frail young woman, frail means very weak, especially the delicate health we can observe. Such type of ladies, they are not at all happy, because reason is the poverty. And again one more thing we can observe, that even though they are working, means everyone they are working, but they are not able to get their means of survival. So here Mukesh attitude is different. Even though such type of problems are there, there is a vicious cycle of middlemen, bureaucrats, and here politicians also, sometimes we can say here sahukars, everyone togetherly they are imposing them. But then also Mukesh is willing to change their willingness, and confirm, he was firm on his decision to become motor mechanic. And that was his decision, because he was willing to become his own master, he will change, and definitely Mukesh's attitude is perfect, and optimism it is observed in his personality, so that we can observe. Then understanding the text. So here, what could be some of the reasons for the migration of people from village to city? So here, especially in village area, nearby industries are not there, good education facilities are not there. In some villages, schools are also not there, health facilities are not there. So villages are not actually enriched with all the facilities. And in some areas, especially irrigation projects are not properly implemented. So many issues are there, especially suppose in Konkan area, some areas are not properly developed, you can say. So most of them, they are preferring to go in Mumbai, and they are not taking proper education also. They are not completing their primary education also properly. And they are unskilled workers. So most of them, they are going and working in very less salary, and they are not living their standard life. And the reason is, one of the reason is illiteracy also. They are not illiterate, and for the sake of survival, most of the time they are migrating from one place to another place. Second reason would be, we can think that natural calamities, nearby areas, if they are not getting enough money, then they would attract towards the city area for the means of survival. And you can add your own points in that. Would you agree that promises made to poor children are rarely kept? Why do you think this happens in the incidents narrated in the text? So here we can observe again one important thing in that. First thing is, we have to think about everyone. We have to think about everyone in a sense that we are not thinking about the poor people. We may just give them some promises, and that we may not keep. Especially here, this statement, it is about the politicians, that every election in on their agenda, they are keeping some important things for the society and for poor people, but they may not keep their promise. So here in this lesson, it is about the school. So here narrator said half jokingly that if I will set up the school, will you be able to come there, or are you interested in that? So here that boy again he asked, and here shamefully, or in that embarrassment, here narrator was also ashamed, because he was thinking about that. Sahib was hopeful that something would happen, but most of the time there are such type of projects which the ruling party or others also, if they would announce, they should keep their promise, because in independence, especially in the democracy, everyone should keep the promise, and they should also enjoy the freedom. That we can focus. Then why do you think this happens in the incidents narrated in the text? So here also instance, so example, proper example, and why it happened. So that all things here you can also mentioned. Especially you can state about they were the migrants, and especially due to such type of poverty, they used to live in such a crowded place. It was like a slum area, and their occupation was like they were rag pickers. So we can understand their condition, and nobody here cares about them, their social injustice. And if there is no prestige for them, then no one will go there and give them support. You can observe any film star or someone, if something would happen to that, or any person, politician, if something would happen, then everyone, the media, everyone will go there and will ask. But if something would happen to any poor person, very few media persons, they will go there and they will help them. So in some cases, media is playing good role, but most of the time, they are just fond of their own channel. So print media, electronic media, most of the time, they are doing good work, but in some cases like this, they are not highlighting. So the progress is still not there in such type of area. So here you can give the example from the text. Then what forces conspire to keep the workers in the Bengal industry of Firozabad in poverty? So here clearly it is mentioned, page number 9, here it is mentioned that two important things here mentioned in that. One of the family caught in wave of poverty, burdened by the stigma of caste in which they are born. So they are thinking about the orthodox world, orthodox society. That society will, what the society will think. They are not thinking that they should go against the family traditions. So some students, they will accept whatever their forefathers, fathers, they are doing, and they will join that same work. Because here there are some statements we can focus specially. It is his karma, his destiny. Mukesh's grandmother, who has watched her own husband go blind with the dust from the polishing of glass bangles. And again here one more thing we can focus. Can a God-given lineage ever be broken? So here she was mentioning about that, and it is a kind of tradition. They don't wish to come out from that. Again, here one more she implies, born in the caste of bangle makers, they have seen nothing but bangles in the house, in the yard, in every other house, every other yard, every street in Firozabad. So they have nothing, they have not seen anything else. Everywhere only bangles. So they are born in such family, and that stigma, it is stick to them, so they will not come out from that. But they are in the wave of poverty, and other also forces here conspire. So what are that other sources? The other we see a cycle of saukars, the middlemen, policemen, the keepers of law, the bureaucrats and politicians. So everyone, what they will do, they will togetherly impose that baggage, or they will togetherly harass everyone in bangle makers, and they would keep them in poverty. So that also we can here clearly mention. So you can elaborate answer in that aspect. Then talking about the text, how in your opinion can Mukesh realize his dream? So here you can state your opinion. That you, what is the difference here we are noticing? So first line, everyone we have to mention that Mukesh insists. So here insist word is important. Mukesh insists on being his own master. So this point you have to add. Then I will become a motor mechanic, he announces. So here he was thinking positively about his dream, that he will not join the same bangle making project, but he will think differently and he will progress in that. I will learn to drive a car, he answers. So this also, that his firmness, his willingness, it is also denoting. And at the end also here we can observe that repeated things here. I want to be a motor mechanic, he repeats. This also repetition means firmness, confidence we can observe. And again here here we can observe that he will go to a garage and learn, but the garage is a long way from his house. I will walk, he insists. Again here he was insisting that okay, I will walk, but I will do that. So here we can observe, suppose he would think about something different, and he would not think about that tradition by tradition. There should not be the stigma on their caste that they are born in that bangle maker's family, so they will just produce the bangles. So as per the modern era, suppose somebody wish to do something new, he can do like the Mukesh. So Mukesh will surely be successful in his dream. And Mukesh, like children, will always get the help from others also, because they are courageous, and the person who is courageous will get the way, and he will not be under pressure of others because he was thinking positive. There would be hurdles in his also life, like means vicious cycle will force them, harass him, or he may not be successful in the beginning, but he will learn. We can hope here, we are hopeful about him, that he will learn how to tackle them, and finally he will success. Because suppose you have that strong determination, then there are some good people also in the society will help the Mukesh, and his business will be good, and he will enjoy his life, and he will enjoy actual freedom. Actual means what in our constitution, all that things it is given, that he will actually enjoy his own rights, that fundamental rights to choose his own business, to do as per your, means there should not be burden on someone, that according to their wish we have to work. So like this, here we can observe. Then next question, mention the hazards of working in the glass bangle industry. That here we have already discussed, especially about the blindness. Here especially you mentioned, then hazards here, temperature also, high temperature, dengue cells, atmosphere was not good, and they would, means their eyes are adjusted there. Means in early, especially children are joining that projection, early age group. So when they will become adult, what will happen? They will become blind. And here indirectly it is satirized that how their projects, everything, means we, they were thinking about the Suhag, but when actually their marriage life, when they will come into the adolescence, their eyes will become weak and they may not enjoy their own life. So here we can observe that things and all the hazards, whichever here mentioned, the detailed description that you can write here. Then why should child labor be eliminated and how? So this is the important question for article sake also. So you study this question properly. You can search about the laws which are against the child labor. And here why? Well, you have to first answer why. Because all children, whether they are in the below poverty level or bangle makers or rectifier family, everyone has that right to take education, and that is our fundamental right, and everyone should get. They have also that right, equal opportunity, they should also get equal opportunity to take quality education. So they will again contribute in the progress of the nation. Suppose there are so many children like this, they would be in such type of poverty, then how our nation will become superpower? So when we are thinking to go ahead, okay, then we have to first focus on the poor, those who are in the poverty. We have to sustain them, and that then only we can think that. So nowadays the concept, it is Atmanirbhar Bharat, then only that concept will be successful. And we have to focus on those who are in marginalized society, study them, what is their requirement, and according to their requirement, give them proper training. So central government previously announced a skill development program, give them some such type of project trainings, and we can give them finance also, we can help them in set up in new projects according to their interest. And then our India will become good, means example for, or India will set a good example for the world, so we can say. And here how, means everyone here, students also, they can also help means they can also provide them ideas. Local area politicians or bureaucrats, everyone, those who are educated, can search and can help them. And especially the state government, central government, suppose there are some children, then special schemes are there, hostels are there, those who are migrants, for them also some projects are there. So we can, means according to the new generation, everyone can help them. So here we have to give them equal opportunities for learning, and when they will get the skills, there also development will be as like ours. And here we can mention more points. Think about that. Take out at least 10 points. So it will be helpful for the article writing. So dear students, complete all the things in your notebook. Thank you.